Hey shooters, Downrange 45 here. Planning for this to be a fairly short video. Two things to talk about. One is an update on the inside the waistband holsters. I got another one to add to the evaluation. This one's from Aegis Armory, and I picked up the idea to add this one to the collection by watching a couple of good guys on YouTube, the Armory channel, Pete over there, and then Bill over at Mr. 45 Bullet. And probably a lot of you have seen those two guys. If you haven't, be sure to check out their channels. They're a lot more on top of things than I am. But they have picked up on this guy, Steven, over there at Aegis Armory. And he's putting out a very nice, I guess we're referring to these as hybrid holsters. I only wear them inside the waistband, but I'm sure they'd work great outside as well. I'd probably have to take the clips off to make it work properly. But a number of things to throw at you on this. You know, the claim on this is it's comfortable from day one. The other guys that have talked about these talked about how soft the leather is compared to some of the others. And it's very well made, but the thing about this is, and I agree with that, it's comfortable. I've been wearing it for about a week now, every day, and you know, very concealable, very secure. Now, one of the things that Pete at the Armory Channel talked about, I think he got one for his Glock, is that he said that it gets tighter over time. His was a little bit loose when it first came. Now, I got mine for the Smith & Wesson M&P Shield. Got a little bit more to talk about that, about the Shield later in this video, but mine fit very tight and very secure from day one. It could not be more secure. Fits perfectly. It's just terrific, and with the Shield, you know, it just disappears. I even one afternoon I decided to test it. I was feeling a little bit tired. I even took a nap, like a 1 hour nap or so, just to check it out to see if you could lay down and be comfortable and sort of forget you're wearing it, and no problem. You know, I couldn't even really feel it. So the weight distribution is really good. It fits right. You know, now you got to decide where on your belt is best for you. And I've been wearing this one probably at the 4 o'clock position for the most part, but very good. And of course, the others I've got out here, Crossbreed. This is for the Glock 19, and an Old Faithful holster, and this is for the Beretta Nano. Now, couple of differences here. One thing you will notice about this is that the there's not quite as much leather with the Aegis Armory as there is with, for instance, this is the Old Faithful. It's not quite as long, and of course that probably helps to reduce the price a little bit, because the Aegis Armory was a little bit less expensive, and perhaps you could say that the weight distribution might be just a little bit better with one of these that has a little more leather. The pretty comparable to the Crossbreed, so there shouldn't be a problem there. But you know, I had no problem with the weight distribution on the Aegis Armory, and it was as comfortable or more so. But here is the real selling point, and I'm telling you, this is like the thing that has got me sold on these guys. I'll probably be ordering more from them. 1 week wire to wire. I ordered this on a Monday and got it the very next Monday, and of course that includes a weekend in there, so you might as well say 5 business days, and I had this in my hands. Both the Crossbreeds and the Old Faithfuls are still running, best I can tell, around 4 months. Now, as the popularity for the Aegis Armory grows, you may see some similar issues. You know, if the business gets good enough, he may get behind too. So if you're interested, jump now, because for now it's a very quick turnaround time, and the quality is absolutely fantastic. So I gotta highly recommend Aegis Armory, and I'm probably gonna be ordering another one from him right away. And now let's just get right into, you see some other things strewn around here. This is the beginnings of the site installation, the dovetail site installation on the SIG 1911-22, and I'm going to be getting that to you shortly, but a couple things have come up that have slowed me down a little bit, and so I'm probably not going to be posting anything after this one for at least a week or so. But here is a big bit of news that I have to share with you, and I've already posted on some of my other videos that the M&P Shield is my carry gun of choice. I love it. It's nice and slender. Feels good when I'm wearing it. It feels good in my hand. It shoots well. I mean, I really enjoy it. This is my carry gun. No question about that. Well, a little bit of bad news. I got an advance warning, and probably you're going to be hearing about it pretty soon, but sort of got it through the grapevine a little early that there's about to be a factory recall on these. There's something about the lower trigger, don't have complete details, has not yet been fully released by Smith & Wesson, but I want you to be watching for this. And it's you know, really bad news, because if my particular firearm is affected, that means it's going to have to go back to the factory. There will be a release of exactly what the problem is and the serial numbers that are affected, but the word has come out to the distributors not to ship any more Smith & Wesson Shields until this is worked out. So the heads up is to, you know, be on the lookout for that. If you already own a Shield, then you're going to need to check your serial numbers and see if you're involved in the recall. If you're looking for a Shield, then you probably better, it might be a good time to wait and see how this shakes out, because, and it could be hard to get them for a little while, but just keep an eye out. Some of the early places to find this out would be perhaps if you already own one, the dealer where you bought it. He should get some of the most early releases, fully detailed releases on this. Smith & Wesson's website, I'd be watching that, and if you don't find that either place, then, you know, Google it and see if anything comes out on this. But I heard about it today, kind of an inside connection I've got. I wanted to get this out on the air right away to let you know about it, but it looks like there is going to be, to some degree, a factory recall on some models of the Smith & Wesson M&P Shield. Okay. Main thing, Aegis Armory, love the holster. You know, this is fantastic. It's just a shame that I've been waiting for this type of holster for the Shield for a while. I mentioned earlier I've had one on order from Crossbreed for 2.5 months, no word on that. Just got it, really starting to enjoy this holster with this firearm. Now I find out there may be a recall on the Shield. So just my luck. I'll probably have to go back to the Nano for a while. Okay, like it if you like it. And please subscribe. Downrange 45, signing off.